When Yaakov blessed his children before his passing on from this world, he said to Yehuda, "Le'yaso shevet mi Yehuda u'mechoykik mi ben raglov, ad ki yaveshile ve'lo yikas amim." The scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor the student of the law from between his feet, until Shiloh comes, and to him will be a gathering of people. Basically, Yaakov promised kingdom to the tribe of Yehuda, as we know that King David, to whom God promised eternal kingdom, was a descendant of Judah. But this concept has also a deeper idea, as with everything else in Torah. In Gemara Kedushin, the Talmud relates that Rabbi Tarfon and the elders were asked a question: what is greater, Talmud or Maaseh? Study of Torah or action? So Rabbi Tarfon answered, action is greater. Rabbi Akiva responded, study is greater. At the end, he all said that study is greater because it brings towards action. Let us understand here the difference between serving God through Torah and serving God through Avodah, which means action, mitzvot. We have a commandment to study Torah and to perform mitzvot. The question is, which is the higher ideal? Learning, by its very definition, means that the learner grasps and understands the subject being learned. As the Torah is God's wisdom, the very concept of learning Torah means that we are grasping and understanding something godly. Yet, it is limited to our level of capability of understanding. Mitzvahs, on the other hand, are mostly have to do with performing an act. Action is something we can do even without identifying, without understanding the purpose of this and the meaning of this action. Action really represents subordination to something higher than ourselves. The very nature of observing mitzvahs is putting one's own agenda aside, just fulfilling the will of the Creator. So in short, learning Torah enhances us. We are learning, we are understanding, whereby mitzvahs enables us to rise above ourselves and fulfilling a command of the Creator. Interesting. Yosef and Yehuda. Rachel named her son Yosef, saying, God will grant me another son, Hosafa, adding in our own self accomplishment, building, increasing, and growing eternally. Leah called her fourth son Yehuda. Yehuda comes from the word hoda'ah, which means to thank. But it also means admission, even confession, which this associates with the setting aside of oneself in recognition of something else. Interesting, that question was never really answered. If study is greater or Talmud is greater. All it says is that Talmud is greater because it brings to action. So obviously, action is greater. So what is it? Is it action or Torah? Friends, we need to do both. But here is the meaning. Yosef and Yehuda, in their esoteric meaning, are a deep spiritual contrast between elevation of one side and subordination on the other side. Kabbalah and Chassidus teaches that this is in fact the divine meaning in the historic tension between Yehuda and Yosef, as we have learned in the parsha of last week. And it's between Yehuda, the kingdom of Judah, and the kingdom of Israel. But there will come a time when the matter will be resolved in favor of Yehuda, as it says, Avdi David Nasi Aleim. My servant David, descendant of Judah, will be king over them. It is Yehuda that will prevail. Meaning, in the days of Mashiach, which will be the time when God in his ultimate self will be our reality. Our learning Torah will not be identified with my understanding, but our learning Torah will be identified with God's presence, God's understanding. God will be our reality. And therefore, what will be, there will be a fusion of Yehuda and Yosef, that even the learning of Torah will be considered like an action today, a selfless action, beyond all our limitations, beyond our own understanding, because we will be able to grasp God's understanding, not limited to our own intellectual capabilities. May God help us for this to realize, to materialize today.